For decades, opium has been the cash crop for thousands of Shan state farmers. But yields are falling and prices fluctuate. 54-year-old poppy farmer Long San is one of 400 growers who last year joined a UN-backed crop substitution program.
I have high expectations that I will make good money from coffee. When I plant poppy, I have to worry about eradication, and I also know it's not good for society.
So far, government efforts to cut down on poppy growing have done little to deter growers. A UN survey says that more than 57,000 hectares of poppy were cultivated in this region last year, almost three times the area farmed in 2006. That has made Myanmar second only to Afghanistan in production. But drug traffickers can be bad business partners. The UN's Jochen Wies says farmers have a better option.
You have to find something which is economically competitive and also sustainable. And we having here is the altitudes in between 1,000 and 1,700 meter, where the main poppy production takes place. And this is just the precise area where you can grow high quality coffee.
It will be a few years yet before these coffee plants are ready to harvest. But in the meantime, growers receive seeds, tools and training. There are currently 200 hectares of coffee under cultivation, with hopes that that could expand to 600 by the year's end. Complicating efforts, however, is the ongoing struggle for territory between ethnic armed groups and the government, both of whom the UN has had to come to an agreement with. For now, the young coffee plants occupy just a tiny fraction of Shan State's vast poppy